This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part 7 of nonlinear systems of equations. And we're going to do this example where we find the points of intersection on the graphs of these two equations. Now, you might recognize the pictures of these two equations. This first one happens to be an ellipse. And the second one is a hyperbola. And that's because we have the minus sign here. So if you recognize that, you might get a picture in your head of, you know, an ellipse looks something like this. I'm not sure if it's wider, if it's more up or down. But the hyperbola, you know, maybe it doesn't touch that at all, which means there would be no points of intersection, right? Or maybe it goes something like this and there might be 4 points of intersection. So we've got more than one possibility depending if that hyperbola touches the ellipse at all. Okay, so this is a natural addition or elimination method type of problem for solving this system because we've got the x squareds lined up and the y squareds lined up and none of them have a coefficient of 1. So we would like to either eliminate the x squared terms or the y squared terms, and there's 2 distinct possibilities that I would use. I would either multiply the top by 2 so that I would get a 6y squared, and that will cancel with a negative 6y squared. So that's one possibility, okay? Somebody else might say, well, how about if you multiply the bottom equation by negative 2, then you will have a negative 4 squared for x squared with this positive 4x squared. And so there are 2 ways you could solve this. It's up to you which way you want to do it. I'll go ahead and do it this way since that's the last thing I wrote, but just keep in mind that is not the only way to solve this. So I'm not going to multiply the top equation by anything, so I'm just going to write that over again. 4x squared by 3 plus 3y squared equals 4. And the bottom equation, I've got to multiply all terms on both sides of the equation by negative 2. So this becomes a negative 4x squared, a plus 12y squared. Oh, I just noticed I accidentally wrote y cubed, just a copying error, and equals positive 6. So if I add these two equations, I see the x squared terms are going to add up to 0, right? So that gives me 15y squared equals 10. All right, so let's first solve for y squared by dividing both sides by 15. And we've got y squared equals, well, you just reduce this by dividing the top and bottom by 5, 2/3. So y squared equals 2/3. Now, after I do this, I could solve for y, but this is going to be useful to remember right here. If y squared equals 2/3, when I go back and substitute in here, I already know what y squared is. So I'm going to keep in mind y squared is 2/3. But I need to also solve for y. So y, you would take the square roots of both sides, right? So it's going to be plus or minus the square root of the square root of 2/3. And I see I'm going to have to rationalize the denominator here, so I'm going to multiply inside the square root by 3 over 3. That's the same thing as if on the outside you just did square root of 3 times square root of 3. So what does that give me? Y equals plus or minus. So in the numerator I'll have square root of 6, and the denominator I'll have just 3, because that's really the square root of 9, which is just 3. So I've got 2 possibilities for y. Okay? So I see what y is. I'm going to keep that in mind. I know what y is, a few possibilities for y, and I see that y squared is 2/3. All right, so what's the next step? I need to find out what x squared equals. And so I could plug this value. There's 2 different values of y, but here's what's important. If I square this, right? If I square this y, I will get back to y squared equals 2/3, whether or not I plug in square root of 6 over 3, or if I put in negative square, it's a 6 over 3. So we could plug in the first number and get an answer. When we plug in the second value of y, we'll get the same answer for x. So keep that in mind. So let's take this, we need to solve for x now. So how about if we take the second equation? So we're going to take that 2x squared minus 6y squared equals negative 3, and let's plug in 2/3 for my y squared over here. Okay? So we have 2x squared minus 6 times 2/3. That is a shortcut to plugging in square root of 6 over 3, squaring it, reducing it, blah, blah, blah. You're going to get 2/3. So that's why this was sort of important to notice. You already know what happens when you square it. That is just a little time saver. So I get 2x squared minus, right now we can cancel, how convenient, the 3 goes into the 6 twice. So I end up with 2 times 2, so 2x squared minus 4 equals negative 3. And so we'll just add 4 to both sides. Get 2x squared equals 1, divide by 2, so we've got x squared equals 1/2, and just like I did over here with the y squared equals 2/3, I'm just going to keep a note that I know I'm going to solve for x, but later I'm going to have, when I check it, I'm going to already know what x squared is equal to. So if we want to solve for x, what do? We've got to take the square root of both sides, so x equals plus or minus square root of 1/2. And just like I did over here, this is an irrational number in the denominator, square root of 2, so I'm going to multiply top and bottom by 2 over 2. So that will give me x equals, well, in the numerator, we're going to have just square root of 2, in the bottom we'll just have 2, because that's a square root of 4. Okay, so what does this mean? I've got a couple things going on here. Let's see if I can get it all in. All right, so I've got that y equals plus or minus square root of 6 over 3, and I have x equals plus or minus square root of 2 over 2. I'm going to consolidate this all into one page. All right, so here is our original system on the left here. And what do we do first? We solve for y squared, and then we solve for y. Then what we did was we plugged in one of these values for y, let's say the square root of 3 over 2, but we know when we squared it, we would get 2/3. All right, so when we plug that back in, we got that x squared equals 1/2, which means there's two possibilities for x, plus or minus square root of 2 over 2. All right, so imagine you plugged in first the square root of 6 over 3. So let's see, how would you write your answer here? It's a little bit confusing. So let's say we first plugged in square root of 6 over 3 for y, and then we get these two values of x. So when you plugged in square root of 6 over 3, there were two values for x. One of them was positive square roots of 2 over 2, and the other one was negative square roots of 2 over 2. So one of the possibilities was square root of 2 over 2, and the other was negative square roots of 2 over 2. So when you plugged in square root of 6 over 3 for y, right in here, the second equation for y squared, then y squared we plugged in 2/3, etc. So we get these two ordered pairs when we put square root of 6 over 3. But remember, when you plug in negative square, it's a 6 over 3. Y squared is the same thing. You would still be plugging in 2/3. So you know what? You would, for the y values of negative square roots of 6 over 3, you also get those two values of x. So for this value of x, square root of 2 over 2 and negative square root of 6 over 3. And with our negative square roots of 2 over 2, or negative square root of 6 over 3. So in this situation, this is where there are four points of intersection. Now, the only way you know for sure is, well, one way, of course, you could graph it very accurately. That's kind of a pain, but if you have a graphing calculator, not too hard. Or we can plug in one of these values, one ordered pair, and check it. Then the next ordered pair and check it. Next ordered pair and check it. Next ordered pair and check it. I'm going to check one ordered pair. Doesn't really matter which one. So let's say I decide to check that ordered pair into both equations. So let's just do that. We're going to check this third one right here. We're going to check that. And then I'll leave it to you to check the other one. So we're going to check that into each equation. So we take each original equation, 4x squared plus 3y squared equals 4. And then we're going to take the other equation, which is 2x squared minus 6y squared equals negative 3. And we are going to replace our x and our y with the values in this ordered pair, square root of 2 over 2 and negative square root of 6 over 3. So we've got 4 times, all right, x squared. So x is square root of 2 over 2. And y is negative square root of 6 over 3. Oops. Having technical difficulties. There we go. I'm on highlighter somehow. One sec. All right. Trying to make that green. There we go. Okay, so here's the cool thing. When I square the square root of 2 over 2, notice here I'm going to get 1 half. I already knew that from before. So I know that when I do this, you can go directly to 1 half. But if you want, you can multiply it out again and say, well, I'm squaring that. So square root of 2 over 2, square root of 2 squared is 2. 2 squared is 4. So notice that is going to be 1 half. Plus 3, same thing over here. You know that when you square it from up here, you take the square root of 6 over 3 and you square it, you're going to get 2/3. But again, if you wanted to actually see it, you could square the numerator. That'll give you a 6, because it's a square root of 6 squared, and the minus sign squared as well, over 3 times 3 is 9. And notice that does reduce to 2/3. So you could skip and go right to writing 1/2 and this right to 2/3. And so if I do this, I can cancel the 4s, and I can cancel this, which is 3, and 6 over 3 is 2. So what I end up with on the left side of the equation is 2 plus 2, which is 4. Okay, that's the left side. Now the right side is 4. So it certainly checked. This solution checked in the first equation. Now we're going to check it in the other equation. And I'm going to do this a little bit faster. What do we know that x squared is going to be? Well, it's going to be 1/2, right? So if you want, you could just put in, you already know that's 1/2, correct? No matter what you put in for x, either of these, you're going to get 1/2 for x. Minus, what about the y squared? So look back up here. When you plug in negative square roots of 6 over 3, either one of them, you know, y squared is 2/3. So I'm just doing a little shortcut on this one. And what cancels? It's got 1, and here is going to be, there's a 2 there. So don't forget, that means we have 1 minus 4, which is negative 3. And I've got negative 3 on the other side. And so this solution checked in both equations. Now, you can see what it would take to check all the other ones, but you're going to have, they're all going to look exactly the same, because whether I put a negative square root of 2 over 2 or a positive square root of 2 over 2 in here, I'll get the 1/2 right here, 4 times 1/2. Whether I put negative square root of 6 over 3 or positive square root of 6 over 3, I'll get 2/3. Same thing in this equation. So if you try any of these other ordered pairs, your check should look pretty much the same. So that means up here, we really do have the correct solution. Let's see, here it is. There's four ordered pairs. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.